Today we're going to talk a little bit about Magneto. Now, I don't really need to go over how much of a badass Ian McKellen was as Magneto back in the Fox X-Men movies, do I? I mean, I think the body of work pretty much speaks for itself here, folks. Let's be honest. And even before McKellen, David Hemblin wore the Magneto helmet and did the voice for X-Men the Animated Series. Now Magneto's disguised as a cat. This article from Bounding Into Comics. New rumor claims to reveal Marvel's top choice for X-Men villain Magneto. Let's dive into it, shall we? Lights, test the stamina, action. I'm a rock star, check the crowd reaction. I'm like, lights, test the stamina, action. I'm a rock star, check the crowd reaction. I really wanted to just kind of talk about this. We'll go through a little bit of the article, but I'm just going to really give you my thoughts here. A new rumor suggests that former X-Men related actor is being sought to don Magneto's signature helmet when he makes his eventual leap to the Marvel Cinematic Universe. The greater question is,
why?
Do we really need another Magneto right now?
It's over there.
I don't remember asking you a goddamn thing.
Sources close to him are claiming that Dan Stevens, who starred in FX's Legion series as David Haller, is being considered for the role of Magneto.
Oh my god, who the hell cares?
Is this something that we need? Can you not bring the X-Men in without doing Magneto? Do you have to introduce him right now? Do you have to race swap him? Dan Stevens would not be a race swap, which leads me to believe that there's no validity to this, even though Mikey Sutton is a fairly reliable scooper.
This man has no dick.
I just don't see them as needing this. You don't have to bring Magneto in, just like you don't have to bring Wolverine in or Cyclops in or any of the mainline X-Men. There's a lot of things you can do, but you don't necessarily need to bring Magneto in right now. This article will go on to say some other things. I'm going to read over a bit of this here. While Sutton's sources are indicating Stevens might be fit for Magneto, they also caution fans to remember that Feige sometimes auditions actors for multiple roles, the most prominent being Tom Hiddleston. He auditioned for Thor, and we all know he got Loki. And it says, of course, the first live-action Magneto is played by Sir Ian McKellen in 2000. Goes on to say, there have been whispers that Giancarlo Esposito was being looked at for the role of Magneto, which I previously reported on, and that would be a race-swapped end of the character. But to that point, Giancarlo Esposito is an absolutely wonderful actor who plays a magnificent villain in Moff Gideon, even in the limited amount of time he's been on screen in Mandalorian. So I ask you again, do we really need this character? Do we really need this right now? If we can't decide if we want to race swap him, not race swap him, why not just hold off on implementing this character? It's probably going to be a number of years before we see him on another on-screen adaptation of him anyway, or interpretation, due to all the delays in filming and things of the like right now with this ongoing nonsense that we're living through in the year 2020, which is almost over. So I ask you again, do we really need this?
Are you fucking high?
But as we said right here, we race swap characters. Marvel has done Heimdall, Nick Fury, and Valkyrie. The only on-screen iteration we had was David Hasselhoff before Samuel Jackson. Valkyrie, nobody cared. Heimdall, I didn't care. Idris Elba's a great actor. Tessa Thompson, well.
Like, I don't want to show up on set and just see a bunch of white people, no offense. And I don't want to work in the company of a bunch of men, no offense.
Mutants done well. For quite a while now, there have been a slow trickle of rumors claiming that assorted Marvel characters would make their MCU debuts in the backgrounds of various upcoming films and shows. Omega Red in The Falcon and Winter Soldier, Omega Red, Spiral, and WizKid showing up in Shang-Chi and The Legend of Ten Rings. However, these rumors have only served to fuel concerns about whether mutants are better off on their own rather than being integrated in the world of the Avengers. YouTuber and Rooster Teeth content partner Grace Randolph, who has one of the most annoying voices I've ever heard, argued as much during her breakdown of Feige's MCU future plans. And at this point, the MCU hype is pretty much just dissipated. And I'm just doing this video kind of as a rant on, I'm tired of hearing different things. Now, I wanted to report this to you because I wanted to give you guys my thoughts, because they keep coming out with articles on this. And this is nothing against Bounding Into Comics. They're doing their jobs. But I want to give my commentary on. I don't think we need Magneto. I don't think we need Professor X right now. I don't want to see another Wolverine. Just leave them, let the characters lie dormant for a while. When you figure out how to do them and do them properly and do them justice, then bring them onto the screen. But don't just bring them on for the sake of bringing them on. That's just my. So I guess my thoughts overall on the character would be I'm apathetic. I don't want to see another interpretation of it right now. I liked Michael Fassbender. I loved Ian McKellen. I don't think that this is a good idea right now. I don't think Marvel can do it right. I don't think they will do it right. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Do you want to see Magneto? Do you not want to see Magneto? Do you care at all about the MCU anymore? Just let me know. And of course, do me that favor and bitch slap that like button for me. Also subscribe. I ask to earn your subscription, and if I have, please let today be the day you press that red button. With that being said, I'm Etep Okuyan from the Place to Be Reviews. I've been here with all the yous, and remember, if I don't see you, have a great day, a pleasant tomorrow, and I'll catch you on the next one.